take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I got the horses in the back, horse track is attached. Hat is mad as black, got the boots as black to match. Riding on a horse, you can whip your Porsche. I've been in the valley, you ain't been up off that porch. How can nobody tell me nothing? You can't tell me nothing. Can nobody tell me nothing? You can't tell me nothing.
Today we're just setting up the awning and everything, getting ready for the weekend to come. I'm hoping it's going to be dry. It would lead to some good racing around at Alton.
Just dropped his race rims off. I'll take them as bare rims just to make their life a bit easier. You never know when you need a bit of their help. And then they'll fit them, balance them, so make sure there's no vibrations in the wheels for the driver. Collect them at this end, fit them to the car. On a day like today, I've got quite a lot to do. Obviously, I drive the lorry here, so I've got to park the lorry up, get the awning set up with a couple of the guys, get it all set up with the tiles out, awning sheets on, wash the truck down, get the car out, get the wheels off the car, get race wheels on, just make sure it all looks clean and tidy, so from the outside it looks good. Just making sure it's all ready to go.
And then obviously you want to get straight back to the power, obviously full throttle, but it would stop you from nearly running wide.
Yeah.
Because you probably just got away with it there.
You want to do slight mobility stuff with him just to get him aware. So his reaction stuff, he's got his little, if he gets them out in a minute.
Take a look around me, taking pages from a magazine. Been looking for the answers ever since we were 17. You know the truth can be a weapon to fight this world of ill intentions. A new answer to the same question. How many times will you learn the same lesson? I think they got it all wrong. We just gotta hold on and on and on and on.
Three races, so you'd have qualifying on a Saturday in the morning, and then you would race in the afternoon. But because of the way Alton Park is always shortened on the Sunday, basically it's because of the local church, we can't be out until around 11-12, so after church. So tomorrow will be free practice in the morning, qualifying in the afternoon. Just had our first session, not a bad first session. He's learning a lot, he's learning what we want him to do to advance in qualifying. It's all about qualifying at the end of the day. There's such a strong grid this year, there's 27 on the grid. So we need to get him as far up the grid as possible so he has a chance to do top 10, top 5 finishes.
Qualifying is one of the most important things at this track as well. You need to start somewhere like from first to about top 12. Because when you start behind, you start on hills as well, which would hinder your start. On the first lap, we were just getting everything warm, getting the tyres warm, getting the brakes warm, getting everything ready to go and crack on with the rest of the session. And I managed to get up into, I was P14 at the beginning, and then later on I got faster and faster. I managed to get into P10. When we're going around, we've got to make sure we get everything. We managed to stay up with the pack in front of us and hope we can break away and get a very good racing between all of us. I think I can maybe get a few extra positions up as well and see where I finish in the race. Thank you to Josh Parker as well for setting the car up and getting everything ready for me and making me get such a good quality. As well, thanks to my dad and my family really for being here supporting me. And then thank you to all my sponsors as well for following me through and helping me through this career.